What is up, fish fam? This is Wireless Riot, and before I drown you in sea-related puns, let's dive right in to Mythic Ocean. Mythic Ocean is a narrative experience that starts you off as the advisor to the gods. So every time a new world is created, a new creator is chosen. The other characters in the game are all gods. They don't know that they're gods. They have no memory of you, and they have no memory of each other. So your job is to, truthfully, teach them interpersonal skills. So the game is really cute. You're swimming through the ocean. You have, it's in a first-person point of view, so there's no actual character. So you're not sure what you look like. But the important part here is that you are showing the gods how to either be excellent creators or chaotic. Everything that you do in the game, in the narrative, really matters at the end of the game. Every decision that you make affects the outcome, and it also affects their relationships with each other, which again will affect the outcome at the end of the game. The whole experience is actually really nice. I did find that the narrative dragged a little bit towards the middle. There is a fast travel option that has you travel between the gods as you're talking to them. So it kind of felt a little tedious at that point that you are going from one god to go to the other god, to go to the other god, to go to the other god, and they're all like talking to each other and it's one sentence. But it really only dragged for me in the middle, and then towards the end was a little heartbreaking in spots and really made you think about the decisions that you were making. Are you gonna look at the greater good? Or are you going to preserve the relationship that's happening or the relationship that's developing? So, like I said, every single decision that you make matters in this game. And I really loved that. And I spent a lot of time on some of the decisions really thinking about everything that was being presented to me. So instead of kind of rushing through the narrative and going through it really quick and, you know, jumping from god to god to god to god, I really did stop and think about my choice and how it would affect all of the other gods and the whole situation. And I thought that was really cool. The exploration system is really easy. It is just swimming around. You can also not just help the gods, but you can help the other fish around you, the other sea creatures. There are a lot of little extra things that you can do. There are some things that you can collect that either you can choose to really affect the outcome of the game, or you can choose to ignore that and not go to that part of the game. It's completely up to you. The decision is all yours to make, which is really nice. And again, really made me take a lot of ownership into the game. There's so many narrative games that kind of talk about how your choices matter. Every decision that you make matters, but at the end, no matter what happens, it's still the same outcome. This really does matter. Which brings me to my next point, which is replayability. The game absolutely is super replayable. You can really work on affecting the outcome and kind of, you know, pushing the narrative to where you want it to go, you know? So you can make those choices and go back through the game. It was about probably about 3 hours for me to play the game. The music in this game is absolutely stunning. There were quite a few times where the music and the visuals were just really pretty. The world is super interactive. The fish are all swimming around. The ocean life is swaying in the tides. And there's so much to look at. It really was one of those games that you can kind of like sit there and listen to the music and watch what was going on and look at how the different creatures interact with each other. There's so many little characters that are very silly. There are two party goers that are the life of the party, and they both completely know that the other one doesn't exist. And then there's a goth pufferfish that's like amazing and sings this metal song to you. It was really cute. The whole environment really stood out to me of a extremely vibrant game that did make me want to replay it to go and do different things to see how I could affect the outcome. And at 3 hours, I definitely feel like you're getting your money's worth with that replayability. So my thought really is that it was a absolutely fun narrative game. It did feel like it dragged for a little while, but dig your feet in and keep going because it really is worth it. And there's so much story. You could probably play this game for 10 to 15 hours and still not have the entire story of every character in the game. So I'm excited to keep playing it. This was definitely worth the time and is definitely going to be worth the future time that I end up putting into it. But yeah, thank you guys so much for being here for my review, and I will see you in the next video.
Thank you so much for watching the latest video from I Dream of Indie. We'd now like to take a moment to thank our great indie warriors who support us through channel memberships. Mitchell Hall, Kevalo, Bunny, Bill Tikaz, Christian Cruz, Strict9, Rosie Syntax, Chris Jackson, Nathan Moore, Peach, Adriana Amato, CJR, Jesse, Falco, Lombardi, C. Coyle, and Skepticism. Thank you for all you do for independent games, developers, and publishers. Everybody else, head down to the description box below or head on over to iDreamOfIndie.com. Let's defeat the echo chamber and bring a voice to the voiceless ones in gaming.